Lunch cablar. Lunch cablar is another type of cabled line directional cablar. The main difference in lunch cablar is that we use, instead of a single cabled line section, we use an interdigited cabled line section. This interdigit structure is composed of multiple cabled line sections buried to each other to increase the coupling coefficient. If we remember, we have said that the main disadvantage of the cabled line directional coupler is that it is mainly suitable for weakly coupled coefficient or weakly coupling coefficient. To increase the coupling coefficient, instead of using single coupled section, we can use multiple buried coupled sections, such that each coupled section will introduce a part of the coupling coefficient, so the total coupling coefficient in this case will be larger than the conventional coupled line directional coupler. That's what we are seeing here. Generally, the coupling in coupled line coupler is too loose or very small to achieve a coupling factor up to, for example, 3 or 6 dB. One way to increase the coupling between the edge coupled lines is to use several lines parallel to each other, so that the fringing fields at both edges, from both directions, at both edges of the line, contribute to the coupling. One of the most practical implementation of this idea is Lange coupler, where four parallel coupled lines are used with interconnection or interconnections to provide tight couplings. In this case, we have, this is a coupled line configuration, this is another coupled line configuration, this is a third coupled line configuration, and finally this is a fourth coupled line configuration. So Lange coupler is composed of four parallel coupled lines are used with interconnections. These are the interconnections. These are the interconnections. So this line has the same potential as this line. Also, this line has the same potential as this line and has the same potential as this line. So these three lines are connected to each other, and these two lines are connected to each other with interconnections to provide tight coupling. This coupler can easily achieve 3 dB coupling ratio. So by using this configuration for the coupling mechanism, we can increase the coupling coefficient up to 3 dB. In conventional coupled line directional coupler, maybe the maximum coupling coefficient which can be achieved is only 10 dB. 10 dB, it means that we have only 0.1 bar, point bar of the incident bar will pass to the coupled port. But in the Lange coupler, we can achieve 3 dB coupling. 3 dB coupling means that half of the incident power can be coupled to the coupled port. So 3 dB coupling is greater than 10 dB coupling, because actually the coupling coefficient is in minus. So we have minus 3 dB or minus 10 dB. Alright? So this coupler can easily achieve 3 dB coupling ratio with an octave or more bandwidth. The output of the through in this case is or has a phase shift of minus 90 degrees. So there is a phase shift 90 degrees between the output line port 2 and the port 3. So we have phase shift between the through and the coupled port with about 90 degrees. This is based on the distance or the length of these cable lines are lambda guide over 4. So, in this case, if the coupling coefficient is 3 dB, this means that half of the bar is going to the through and half of the bar is going to the coupled port. And in addition, there is a phase shift 90 degrees between the through and the coupled. This means that this Lange coupler, it can correspond to a hybrid coupler or a quadrature hybrid coupler. If you remember, we have studied before the quadrature hybrid coupler, where the input port is divided between the output two ports with a phase shift between the two ports with 90 degrees. This is the definition of the quadrature hybrid coupler. This means that Lange coupler can be used as a hybrid or a quadrature hybrid coupler. So there is a 90 degrees phase difference between the output lines port 2 and port 3. So the Lange coupler is a type of quadrature hybrid coupler. In the case of the coupling coefficient would be 3 dB. The main disadvantage of the Lange coupler is probably practical, as the lines are very narrow and close together. The spacing between the lines is very small, and the lines themselves are very narrow. So the lines are very narrow and close together. This makes some practical problems in fabrications of such Lange coupler. So very narrow and close together, and the required bonding wire across the line increases the complexity. Also, we have bonding wires between the different lines or the different line sections. This bonding wire corresponds to another problem in the manufacturing process of Lange coupler. So the complexity of fabrication of the Lange coupler is mainly the main problem in such type of couplers. This type of coupled line geometry is also referred as interdigitated, because actually the coupling mechanism is due to interdigit parts of transmission line sections. This is briefly what is meant by Lange coupler. Another configuration for Lange coupler is unfolded Lange coupler. In conventional Lange coupler, we have the input from port 1, and the through is port 2, and the coupled is port 3, and the isolated is port 4. If we folded this arm 180 degrees to be in this side, and folded the other arm 180 degrees in the other side, we can get this line connected directly to this line. So it will compose a single line like this. On the other hand, when we folded this by 180 degrees, this line will be composed to this line. Alright? And the middle line here is this middle line here, because this will be connected to the port 2, and this is the port 3, is the coupled one. So in this case, we are folding. The port 3 will remain at its direction, but the port 2 and port 4 will be interchanged. In this case, we have just a straight line coupled to an internal strip, and this internal strip is connected to another straight line, and here there is another straight line. Once again, if you look at this configuration from the point of view of coupled line section, we have one coupled line section between this arm and this arm, a second coupled line section between this arm and this arm, And a third coupled line section between this arm and this arm. So we have three coupled line sections. 1, 2, and 3. Here we have 4. But actually the 4, we have half here and half here. So we connected both of the halves in one direction. This type of unfolded lunge coupler is easier for fabrication because actually we have less bonds. Here we have 4 bonds or 4 wire bonds. Here we have only 2 wire bonds. Okay. So the unfolded lunge coupler operates in essentially the same way of the original lunge coupler, but it is easier to middle with an equivalent circuit and is easier for fabrication too. Actually, we are going to present the analysis of the unfolded lunge coupler. For the unfolded lunge coupler, we can present the equivalent circuit as 4 lines. Each 2 are connected with short circuit. So, for example, this is line 1 and this is line 3. Line 1 and line 3, and they are connected with short circuit, this short circuit. And here, line 2 and line 4, line 2 and line 4, and connected with the bond wire, short circuit here. This combination of line 1 and line 3 corresponds to the first arm. And line 2 and line 4 correspond to the second arm. The input in this case is going from port 1 and the through is to port 2. The coupled signal is port 3 and the isolated signal at port 4. Effectively, if we look at this geometry, it is simply like the coupled line directional coupler, but instead of using just a single coupled line section, we are using 2 coupled line sections interlaced together. So the unfolded lunge coupler here has this equivalent circuit, which we are going to study to obtain the coupling coefficient and the isolation and the matching to the input port as the same steps for the coupled line directional coupler. The equivalent circuit for each 2 parallel lines is simply a coupled line section with even characteristic impedance Z not even and odd characteristic impedance Z not odd. So in this case we have a coupled line section between 1 and 2 and another coupled line section between 2 and 3 and third coupled line section between 3 and line 4, and each one has even and odd characteristic impedance Z not even and Z not odd. And for simplicity, it is assumed that the widths of all the lines are the same and the separation between the lines are the same, so that the even and odd impedance for the 3 sections will be the same. So all of the lines have the same width and spacing. If we make a reasonable assumption to each line, couple only to the nearest neighbor and ignore more distant coupling, then we effectively have 2 wire coupled line in this fork. Okay? For the 4 wire coupled line model, there is an even characteristic impedance which we are going to call it Z even 4, and another odd characteristic impedance which we are going to call it Z odd 4. Effectively, the coupling coefficient and the input characteristic impedance for the lunge coupler or for the folded flange coupler depends on Z even 4 and Z odd 4. However, from the point of view of the analysis, we can obtain the even characteristic impedance and the odd characteristic impedance for each line pair. So in this case, we can design Z not even and Z not odd. This means that for specific widths and specific spacing between the lines, we can find out the corresponding Z not even and Z not odd. So it is required from our analysis to obtain a relation between Z even 4, Z odd 4, and Z not even and Z not odd. And if you are interested in the design, we are interested in designing or obtaining a relation between the coupling and the characteristic impedance in terms of Z not even and Z not odd, such that we can obtain the width and the spacing between each two lines together. Alright? So we have the complete model and we have the approximate two-wire coupled line model for each two coupled lines. Alright? Okay? It is required to derive an even and odd mode characteristic impedance ZE4 and Z0 4 of the four-wire circuit in terms of Z0 even and Z0 odd. The even and odd mode characteristic impedance of the adjacent pair of lines. So, this one can be obtained from the charts of the conventional coupled line sections. And it is required to find a relation between the four coupled line section Z even 4 and Z odd 4 and the conventional Z not even and Z not odd. After finding this relation, then apply the coupled line coupler method, the conventional coupler coupled line coupler method on the approximate two wires to obtain the coupled line model. Okay, effectively, the details of these steps will be presented in the following video. So, until now, let us agree on that we have a complete circuit for the four coupled lines together and each two coupled lines have another or approximate equivalent circuit obtained or based on the coupled line theory of two wires. Alright? Okay. See you in the next video to find the analysis of this approximate folded flange coupling.